Michelle Baker, too. Remember that?
Are y'all ready to see JK Studios' first ever movie? Yeah. We are very, very excited to be here. We've never done a premiere in Arizona like this, so this is really exciting. We're really excited about the show, so thank you so much for coming, everybody. Thank you so much. All right. I really don't know what else we should cue them in on. What do you think, Amise? Oh, well, okay. I don't know you well, but I think I'd love you too if I knew you better. Okay, so after this movie, we'll be doing a short Q&A. We'll hang out for about 15 minutes here, and then we'll make our way into the hall where we can take pictures. Now, it's going to be a little bit of a labyrinth to get there. They'll have to go take these, write this down. They'll have to go through.
They'll go through the normal way.
We'll go through the other. Oh, we're going to go through the secret passage. Yeah. Thank you for clarifying.
Well, it's not secret anymore.
Don't worry about it. We'll just be there. We'll walk out of the floor and we'll be ready to take pictures. We're going to be in the lobby, we're going to be hanging out, chatting, we're going to do some pictures, okay? So after the credits, feel free to hang out. If you got to go somewhere, if you got to go see Barbie or Oppenheimer, we get it. Do what you got to do. But we'll be here.
You've already seen it.
I think that's about the gist of it, right? Please feel free to, if you had a good time, tell your friends about the experience. With a low-budget film, like this is with an indie film, that is how we stay in theaters longer.
Especially
that's
going
to allow
weekend.
Us to like make more movies, especially our first one.
Yep.
So, super exciting. All right, enough chit-chat. Y'all ready to get this party started? Let's go! Let's do it. Let's roll. Not that's fine, because to sit down.
Just walk
away. Just walk in. Should I just talk the whole movie?
Sure!
We're going to talk all over all of Matt's lines.
The movie magic. that's another question. Yeah,
what inspired you to start Studio C?
What inspired us to start Studio C? We got bored and we're like, we should do something and try to make money. We were doing all of this in college, actually, in a group called Divine Comedy. That's how we all met in college, so we've been together a very long time. And we liked that. And then the chance came to do it at UATV, and so we did it. And then time came to do JK Studios, and I don't know if you've watched any of our JK Studios stuff.
Watched all of them.
If you haven't, it's on YouTube, and it's very much like Studio C.
Yeah.
Maybe even more fun. Who knows? I'm not the judge of that. But I am, and it is. another question.
Right here in the front.
Where's the lady with the black curly hair?
Oh.
Where's the lady with the black curly hair? That's Robert was played by Whitney Call.
Didn't she do great? Yeah. Wasn't she great in it?
She did not come because I came, and we have three children. So she'll be here next time. Yeah, the kids were in the movie. They were in the circus. Little Georgia.
Oh no.
But yeah, Robert was for sure one of our favorite characters. She just is so fun to us. I mean, Cora's amazing. Hank's amazing. I feel like there's so many fun characters that we got to play in this movie. And we just love them all. Any other questions? Yeah. Favorite scene to film? Campfire scene? I feel like Stacey wrote that song, but you can do anything. And again, a shining Cora moment where Mal's line in the script is just, "I want to see a man go over a waterfall." And then she just riffed on it for a while. It was so cold. It was amazing.
I think it's like the line started with, "I want to see a man die." And then it was like, well, she lives in 1800, so they've probably seen a ton of people die. All of Adeline's boyfriends. And then Adam was like, "How about over a waterfall into the mist?" And then Mal was like, "Got it." And then went on this wild, dark mountain. I don't know how many times I've seen this movie. I literally was catching things I haven't seen before, and I like wrote this movie with my friends, right? So that gets me every time. But my favorite scene to film, I just really enjoyed just the singing and the dancing at the Donner Party was just a good time. We were in a tent, I had layers on, it was warmer, yeah, like that one.
The river crossing scene for me, it was a lot of this where I'm set that day. It was one of our warmer days. Steven had to do all the work. It was great.
I loved all these scenes so much, filming all those scenes, but I think it was the second or third day of the whole shoot was the scene where we meet Robert. And I think it was the first time on set that I was like, oh, this could be kind of a fun thing that we're doing. Because you see Robert and she has such a strong entrance into the movie that I was like, this is really fun. So I liked filming that day a lot.
It was the very first thing that we shot, but I really liked shooting the torture scene with the where Steven, you know, his hair secedes from his ear again.
And I really love the conclusion of the whole thing with the buffalo and everything. It just feels like a nice tie-in with the golfers and all of that. It's just
a lot to love.
What scene took the most takes? Jeremy, you directed, and Steven, do you guys remember?
I don't remember. Probably.
We didn't take a lot of time to film anything.
Yeah. The end took the most time. There were just a lot of setups, so I don't know if there were quite as many takes. There was a lot more setups, but the thing that probably had the most takes, I don't know. Was there something that we were trying to get?
Delmar coming out of the tent, he slipped a lot, and then... There's one part where the golf ball hits Mallory and she kind of falls down. And if you watch really closely, you can see she starts to smile and she starts to break. I feel like we did that so many times that she just laughed and laughed and laughed. That was kind of tricky. And the part where Matt's staring you down.
Oh my gosh.
Matt, when I finished playing the guitar, we did several takes of Matt just like captain looking at me. And I couldn't look at him because I would break. Well, I think one of my favorite memories is we're filming the part where Cora's snoring. That's the thing, we laugh sometimes and like jokes are in there, so you'll hear different ones, but she's like, "Scat." But when she starts scatting, I remember looking around at the crew. Everyone's like covering their mouth. People are like walking away from set because everyone's trying so hard not to laugh. Do you remember that? I don't know how y'all kept it together.
It was the last day of filming,
and there was a wedding being filmed in the room over.
A wedding happening.
You know, we were filming. And they were playing music super loud. They played like Mr. Brightside and a Village People song, so it was kind of like, okay, we're doing. Yeah, another question. Let's go to the very, very back. Yes, sir.
The September calendar with the 21st, who's the Earth, Wind, Nice catch. The September calendar with the 21st. Who was that? You
it's a Jeremy Warner classic.
I just wanted to make sure that you remember the 21st night of September. So I just gave you all 30 days.
Good catch.
There's also 12 days of Christmas if you see it again. And 34 days of January. Right there. That's a good question. Usually, we kind of write. We all know each other so well, and we know each other's strengths, and so we kind of just write the characters for whoever. Like I would say, most of it we kind of cast based off of just the writing, right? Like as we wrote it.
And Natalie, you
is that a satisfactory answer?
Yeah, I think that's right. There's a few, like the kind of the core. Abilene, Cora, and Elijah. We kind of had an idea of what we thought casting would be, but the order of operations here to write the script was sketches first, scenes first, like the little funny vignettes first. So we wrote all those, and we kind of knew there would be sisters going along the trail. We didn't know much more than that. We didn't really have the whole company fleshed out. So we just wrote sketches that we thought sounded fun. Me and Whitney and Mallory took about 30 of these sketches that we've written as a group, and we just hunkered down for a long weekend, and we just came up with like kind of the story arc of how to tie it all together. And that, I feel like, was when we really cast everything. But for a very long answer to your question is, the writer usually casts it. But it kind of depends. It kind of depends on like, oh, this person isn't in a lot, let's make sure they're over there, if that makes sense. But if it's a person playing like a specific character, it was usually them who wrote it. Usually. Not all the time, but usually. Maybe one or two more? Yes, right here. How do we get the snakes not to bite us? I'm gonna blow your mind. Are you ready? They were not real snakes.
The real snake was on the cat's back.
But there was like a plastic fake snake that landed on Matt's head. That was a fun day. Yes, right here.
Okay. Was it funner to write the movie or shoot the movie?
Was it funner to write the movie or shoot the movie? Shooting was extremely cold.
Yeah, I'll let somebody else answer. Go
for it. I love filming. I just love the whole film process. Oh, so
it was so cold outside.
It was fun.
My electric Costco socks broke twice. Thankfully, they have a really good return policy. And I was like, y'all, it's not handling 12-degree weather. What can we do? But I thought the writing was really fun. It felt like a callback for me to like, like sketch writing days, and like it reminded me of like Studio C and Divine Comedy. We're just like in a living room laughing. Filming it was really fun too.
Yeah, I would say writing, I love writing, but you do that mostly by yourself. And then, but when you're filming, you just hang out with your friends, and then you're all like, we're cold together.
Cold together. A couple more?
Yeah. Let's go to this kid right here, curly hair. How long did it take to film? We filmed for 3 days. 3 days. 3 weeks.
Did you work on?
3 weeks. 15 days.
15 and a half.
When Adam is laying on the blanket in Nebraska, we shot that at 4 o'clock in the morning in October in the mountains. It was pitch black outside. And Natalie's close up as well, because the weather was so crazy. So technically we shot for 15 and a half days, because one of the days got screwed up and we had to shoot at 4 in the morning.
One in the back section.
The guy in the cap, yes.
How did you decide on the red boots?
The red boots
decided on us.
Yeah, they chose us.
Well, it was, you know, it was what he offered, you know, the Beelzebub.
Mallory had kind of like a sketch idea, she's had it forever, of basically the premise of like, you sell your soul to the devil for something terrible. Like, what a terrible thing to cash that in on. And some sort of like ugly hat was kind of her idea. And I'm assuming it was both Mallory and Whitney's brainchild to make it so amazing. Whitney and Steven like bedazzled stuff. And here's our beautiful costume.
Stand
right
up
here.
For us.
So if you want any custom boots, she's your gal.
amazing. They will be iconic forever. Yeah. Are we doing one more?
There are four people pointing to this guy.
This guy that's being pointed at. In the green?
The red.
Oh, that boy?
So
many layers.
I'm sorry. Oh, there's like this, this child. Yes. Right there. How do we make the beast? That was computers too.
Yeah.
Oh, we did have a bison head.
There was a shot coming at me.
Yeah, there was a camera shot over his head for a little bit. In red right here.
Do you guys think you're ever
going to
make another movie?
We hope so. It will be called Go Back, and we have lots of ideas that go more with. We've got a lot of working titles for it. But that's why you all being here right now is amazing. That's why opening weekends are really important. If we can make enough money on this movie, we will absolutely be putting it into a new movie. So we would love you to tell people, use the hashtag Go Watch the Movie, and get people out to the theaters, because that will be huge in helping us make another movie for sure.
Yeah.
And it's like, I think Adam right now is working on like a Christmas heist movie. Matt's tossed around an idea of like a train like robbery or something. There's just like all these ideas, Regency Air. Like, it's like we have all these ideas and we're so excited to make more. How about we do one more? One more question, we'll call it a day. Meese, you be the bad guy, choose.
You haven't done it yet.
I can't handle this responsibility.
Yeah, that lad.
There's so many lads. Fight for it. No, which
whoever
one
talks first gets it. Go.
Alex, talk.
How long did it take for Jimmy to grow
out
his beard?
Ooh, that was a bad question. I'm just kidding. You're first.
I just haven't shaved for 5 years. I love my hair. It's a pretty lackluster. Let's do one more. That kid in the green, they've been pointing at you forever.
No, because I do not know how. So, fun fact, Delmar, the name of Jason's character, is actually named after his father, and who's been a huge part and a huge supporter of us, and he passed away recently, so this is kind of like a really sweet thing, and the first time I met him, he just walked up and like ate food off my plate at Applebee's, and I was like, I like this guy. But we would play golf with him. We'd go up to Idaho and play golf, and one time he was like, anyone come around and play golf, and I was like, I can't. He's like, yeah. And he gave me the golf club and the ball, and I immediately hit it into his boat, and he immediately took it away. It was like, yeah, you're done. So this was for Delmar. Y'all, thank you so much. Did you have a good time today? To work so hard, we've been working on this for over a year, to see it come to fruition and to watch it with you all and enjoy. Like, we literally made it for you, and this is just like our dream come true. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow, we're gonna be out in the lobby. Give us like a minute to run out. Okay, we're ready to set up. And once again, just thank you for coming. Tell your friends about it. All right.
Movie reviews are a bit new to me, so bear with me. I'm just gonna say it, this is the best movie I've seen. I'm not just trying to get recognition from JK Studios, but I wouldn't mind a comment down below. It's got a great plot, a ton of jokes. I watched it yesterday and my ribs still hurt. And I love... I probably shouldn't say, I don't want to spoil it for you. Just, you should go see it, take a selfie with the sign, and tag me and JK Studios. Please consider subscribing.